This is the BBC Home Service.
Back in the dark 1950s in the UK, the radio airwaves were ruled by the BBC. There were just three domestic channels. There was the Home Service, mostly speech with some music. The third programme, with some speech and mainly classical music. And the Light programme, for light music and entertainment. Much of that music was by in-house bands and orchestras, so commercial records featuring rock and roll were few and far between. Around this time, a young lad from Cheshire bought his first pop record.
Wake up, little Susie, wake up.
A schoolmate tricked him into thinking the song was all about him. Wake up, little Scoozy. Within a few years, the young lad, one Keith Skues, would be knocking on the door of Broadcasting House for a job.
My career began with the British Forces Network in radio, and I thoroughly enjoyed that job. And eventually, I was hoping that I could join the BBC. So I went and knocked on the door at Broadcasting House and was politely told to go away. So I went away and met up with a colleague for a drink in central London, and by coincidence, there in that particular pub, although I didn't know it at the time, was a gentleman by the name of Alan Crawford. He was the boss of a radio station called Radio Atlanta. And I went up to the bar and ordered a couple of pints of lager and a packet of crisps or whatever. And he said across the bar, "You sound like you've got a good voice for radio." And basically, he invited me to join Radio Atlanta. I didn't know what Radio Atlanta was. It was brand new pirate radio. And eventually they merged with Radio Caroline. So I ended up in radio and Radio Caroline by pure accident.
And still on the call game, here's another one which comes from Eleanor of Hornsey, London North 8. And I don't think we ought to play this one really, but it says, would you dedicate this record to whom it may concern, i.e. Susan and Keith, thank you. It was the wrong record. Oh, well, it's too bad now. Sorry about that. Susan and Keith, thank you, Eleanor, for a very nice friendly card. And we'll dedicate this one to us.
And this year, Keith Skues is celebrating his own record, and it's a milestone few people achieve. 60 years of broadcasting at the microphone, and for most of that time, his theme tune has been an instrumental version of a song written by Bob Dylan and made famous by the Byrds.
Mr. Tambourine Man was sent to me by a gentleman called Derek Taylor, and he was the publicity manager for the Beatles at that particular time. It was addressed to me, care of Radio Caroline, so it went to Caroline House, which was in Chesterfield Gardens in London. It did eventually reach me after 3 or 4 weeks. And those days, we had complete freedom of the airwaves. We could do what we liked. And I didn't realise at that time that there was great response from listeners saying, "Where do we get this record? Nobody's ever heard of it." Then CBS Records released it, and then it became a chart entry, and it slowly went up the charts. CBS contacted me and said, "Thank you very much. You know, it was due to you that this became a hit record. So we can't offer you any money, but what we can do is offer you the Radio Luxembourg CBS show with effect from January 1966. So I resigned from Radio Caroline and joined Radio Luxembourg presenting the CBS record show. Somebody contacted me and said, "Why don't you use Mr. Tambourine Man as your theme tune?" And I said, "Well, I can't. I need an instrumental version." And the Golden Gate Strings, who were session musicians, came out with an instrumental version of that, which has been my theme tune ever since 1966, right through to this current day.
After the Radio Luxembourg CBS show came to an end, Keith took himself and his theme tune back to the high seas. to board another rocking boat.
This is wonderful Radio London, where you're hearing things,
where you're hearing things.
I joined Radio London from the summertime of 1966, right through until the 14th of August 1967, the Marine etc. Broadcasting Offences Bill became an Act of Parliament. So that was the end of pirate radio as we knew it. So that was really telling us that our days as a pirate were over and done with. And then, of course, the BBC set up BBC Radio 1, and I, having been on Radio London, was asked to go and do an audition, but so did 200 other DJs. And I was very lucky and was offered a programme on Radio 1.
Right, OK, there we go. The letter from the box tops. And that's all for Saturday Club today. I'd like to say very many thanks indeed for all the telegrams and the cards, the good wishes that we've all received here at the BBC in London. We all appreciate it. And to all world listeners, we hope to be with you in the very, very near future. Saturday Club ends, and we'll tell you right now that our guests next week include Kiki D, Amen Corner, Jimmy James and the Vagabonds, and Ebony Keys. All will be helped along by the Rex Morris on In Saturday Club, coming to you next week at 10 o'clock. Stand by now for the Roscoe Show.
Keith Skues presenting Saturday Club on the 30th of September 1967. 7 years later, Keith changed stations again, this time to South Yorkshire, to launch a commercial radio station in Sheffield.
This is Radio Hallam.
Radio Hallam on a Sunday afternoon, the 30th of September. It's 13 minutes past 3 o'clock and we're going back in time.
I'm like a rubber ball, baby.
After over a decade in Sheffield, Keith made his way back to the BBC, where he still presents his popular music show across the eastern counties on a Sunday evening. So we congratulate Keith Skues, MBE, on completing 60 great years behind the microphone.
And friends, this story is true. I know. I was that announcer.